Hello, I'm Xavier Picard, the co-director of the movie The Prince Voyage. When I discovered the film Rowing Across the Atlantic, I felt an emotional shock. At this time, I had never had the opportunity to cross Jean-François Laguillon's path until the day when, at the request of the producer Armel Glorenec and Eric Jacot, I landed in Brittany in the master workshop. Jean-François showed me the first drawing of the voyage, an unconscious man stranded on the beach.
Cuts me. No, not a man, a monkey. Then he tells me about a tale where monkeys are the heroes, and also about several years of preparatory work with the help of Annie Cleret in writing, Jean Palenstein in graphics, and Christophe Herral in music. In order to direct an animated feature film, I said. No, not an animated film, just a film, he corrects me. Oops, I better shut up. Next mixtape, he puts me back on the train to Paris. And then, no, he offers me to get on board to begin the trip, to read, to watch, to propose, to give a stroke of paddle, so that the film can be made. I read, I watched, I proposed, and, as a simple crew member, the master gave me a place on the bridge of the ship with the blessing of the ship owners, Armel and Eric. I put my hand on the tiller next to the captain's and we sailed. The Prince Voyage, a contemporary tale, when we discover the first drawing of the monkey on the beach, how could we not think of all the people who cross the Mediterranean Sea and run aground on our shores. Like them, our monkey, Prince Lankos, will receive an icy welcome and will be studied like a curious animal. A great lover of the arts, an Epicurean, a prince of the Italian Renaissance, is precipitated into a modern world where power is held by an academy of pretentious scientists. A world that believes itself to be unique, that denies the existence of the stranger, that cultivates fear of the other, where certainties and scientific superiority take precedence over nature. The forest fights against the city of the monkeys, a sort of gigantic megalopolis of the end of the 19th century, that we have stylized by thinking of Gustave Doré, but also of Fritz Lang by adding color. The monochrome atmospheres, far from any realism, express the feelings of the characters, all traced by the hand of Jean-François. Some, such as the academician, are inspired by Daumier. The film's direction is deliberately sober and efficient, the editing far from frenetic habits, the animation reduced to the essential. I put my feet in the master footprints and made sure to set the melody to music. Jean-François was the composer, and I, all comparison aside, the arranger and the conductor. I hope that the audience, adults, children, monkeys, and other congeners will share our journey, having fun but also observing, as if in a mirror, the reflection of our life today.
As Fedra said, the merit of the tale is double meaning. It provokes laugh and gives a lesson of prudence. Je vous souhaite un bon voyage.